नमस्कार, माइसेल्फ डॉक्टर दीप्ति बिष्ट, प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ काय चिकित्सा, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. इन टुडेज सेशन फॉर क्लास बीएमएस फोर्थ ईयर, आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द सेशन रिगार्डिंग द डिजीज हाइपोथायरॉयडिज्म. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इंट्रोडक्शन, एज ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट बी अवेयर ऑफ, हाइपोथायरॉयडिज्म is the condition resulting from insufficient synthesis of thyroid hormone. Hypothyroidism, which is dating from birth, is termed as cretinism. Term myxedema indicates the condition of severe hypothyroidism. So these are two or three points which should be remembered. Now, let us discuss about the causes. So first of all, if it is primary hypothyroidism, then cause is idiopathic. Mostly it is goiterous. There is iodine deficiency. Chronic autoimmune thyroiditis may be the cause. Hereditary defects in thyroid synthesis is another major cause. Post ablation cases can also categorized under primary causes. These are like surgery of thyroidectomy, radioactive iodine ablation therapy, some drugs, lithium, or previous radioiodine treatment can lead to hypothyroidism. Now, if we talk about transient hypothyroidism, then under this, there is silent thyroiditis. There may be subacute thyroiditis, post radioactive iodine therapy in Graves' disease, thyroid agenesis may be there, rare thyroid hormone resistance syndrome is also there. Now, secondary hypothyroidism, it is due to pituitary or hypothalamic disorders, like there may be tumors, hemorrhages, or granulomatous or autoimmune diseases. Now, I will share some points regarding transient hypothyroidism. Transient hypothyroidism basically refers to a state of reversible thyroid function, which is often observed during the first 6 months after subtotal thyroidectomy or 131 iodine treatment of Graves' disease. Similarly, in cases of post-thyrotoxic phase of subacute thyroiditis, postpartum thyroiditis, in some neonates, transplacental passage of TSH receptor binding antibodies from the mother with Graves' disease or autoimmune thyroid disease may cause transient hypothyroidism. Congenital hypothyroidism is asymptomatic state, which is usually detected during the routine screening of TSH level in blood, and it is obtained 5 to 7 days after birth. It results either from thyroid agenesis, ectopic hypoplastic glands, or from dyshormogenesis. Early detection and early treatment with replacement thyroxine therapy is mandatory to prevent irreversible brain damage. So, next comes to the clinical features. So some clinical features are there, like skin will be cool, coarse, dry and flaky skin. Hairs usually are sparse, brittle. There may be loss of eyebrows. Nails are brittle. Muscular features are like pain, stiffness, muscle weakness, delayed relaxation of tendon reflexes. Under neurological features, memory impairment, carpal tunnel syndrome may be present. In cardiovascular system, there may be condition of bradycardia, diastolic hypertension, cardiomegaly with pericardial effusion, cold intolerance. In case of GI symptoms, there may be macroglossia, there may be gastrointestinal hypomotility, which results in usually constipated state of bowel. Ascites may be present. In case of female, there are usually complaints of menorrhagia or amenorrhea. Infertility is one of the common signs. Then abortion. In male, the usual symptoms are impotence, scrotal effusion. Metabolic features are hypothermia, hypercholesterolemia. In respiratory symptoms, we have vocal cord edema leading to low pitched and hoarse voice. Pleural effusion may be there. If we do the hematology, the findings will be normocystic, normochromic anemia, iron deficiency anemia may be there, and megaloblastic anemia is also present sometimes. So the basic symptoms which are usually seen or which patients usually complain are tiredness or malaise, weight gain, anorexia, cold intolerance, poor memory, depression, psychosis, deafness, poor libido or loss of libido. In some cases, there may be goiter. Eyes usually are seen as puffy eyes, or there may be periorbital swelling. Hairs are dry and brittle. There may be arthralgia, myalgia, constipation, as I have told earlier. And if you talk about the basic signs which are more prominent, are like mental slowness is there, ataxia may be there, deafness, dry and thin hair, loss of eyebrows, sometimes hypertension, hypothermia, anemia, pericardial effusion in undiagnosed and chronic cases. There may be edema, large tongue, that is macroglossia, dry skin, mild obesity may be there. Sometimes goiter is also seen. And reflexes are mostly slow in case of hypothyroidism. Now, investigations. The investigations which we usually do in case of primary hypothyroidism, if we do the thyroid profile, we will get high thyroid stimulating hormone with low T4 and low T3, which is diagnostic. Thyroid autoantibodies usually comes positive if it is an autoimmune disease like anti-TPO, anti-macrosomal, and anti-thyroglobulin antibodies. ECG is low voltage due to the presence of pericardial effusion. There may be hyperlipidemia due to the condition of high cholesterol. Normocytic, normochromic anemia is usually seen. X-ray chest is also observed, which can reveal the pericardial effusion. In case of secondary hypothyroidism, T4 and T3 and TSH, these all are low. Now, treatment is usually done with replacement therapy by supplying synthetic preparation of levothyroxine in the dose of 100 to 150 microgram per day in single dose. If it is secondary hypothyroidism, then replacement therapy is given, but other hormones replacement are also required, like cortisol deficiency should be treated simultaneously to avoid adrenal insufficiency, and this is done basically if there is any endocrine disorder related with adrenal gland. In case of subclinical hypothyroidism, when thyroid stimulating hormone level is elevated with normal T4 and T3 values, and there are vague symptoms, that is, the symptoms are mixed or confusing types, then also if associated goiter or positive antibodies, then it is treated with thyroxine. If not, then thyroid stimulating hormone should be repeated after 3 months. If it is rising, it is suggestive of progressive hypothyroidism, and then thyroxine should be given. So this was all the treatment regarding the hypothyroidism and its clinical features and signs and symptoms. Some one or two points which should be we should know regarding two common causes of diffuse goiter, which can be seen in this hypothyroidism condition. one another thing, if hypothyroidism is present by birth, then in this condition, the growth of child becomes very slow, and this is called cretinism, where the clinical features are a child showing short stature, retarded growth, with coarse features like the face will be edematous, there will be thick and dry skin, lips will be thick, and the kid will have mental retardation, and all these features are developed at the age of 1 year. In case of juvenile hypothyroidism, the stature is usually short with retarded growth, and in cases of females, there may be condition of amenorrhea, and secondary sexual characters are not developed, and the coarse features on the face like thick lips, edematous and wrinkled face is often seen. Now the difference between simple diffuse goiter and goiter due to Hashimoto's thyroiditis, which is usually seen. These are, in case if there is simple diffuse goiter, this is usually seen in young girls or during pregnancy. Similarly, thyroid enlargement may be mild, goiter may be soft, non-tender. Symptoms are usually asymptomatic patient, and only there is sensation of tightness around the neck. Cause may be suboptimal dietary iodine intake and minor degree of dysthormogenesis. Thyroid state may be normal and thyroid antibodies are usually negative. But if the goiter is due to Hashimoto's thyroiditis, then it is mostly common in young females of age group 20 to 50 years. Here the thyroid enlargement is seen, very large, goiter is firm and tender. There is pain radiating to jaw or neck, increased during swallowing, coughing and neck movement. Also, since this is an autoimmune disease, so 25% cases are hypothyroid at presentation and others become later on. And if we test the thyroid antibodies or TPO antibodies, then this comes positive in case of in 95% case. Also, if we see the features of myxedema, there are myxedemic changes like dry, toad, like skin, puffiness of face, hands and feet, larynx, there may be some hoarseness of voice and slurred speech. And majority of women which are present with rapid increase in weight, menstrual irregularities, mental features or slowness of activity with generalized aches and pains are the usual signs of hypothyroidism. So these are the some point of differentiation regarding hypothyroidism. Treatment is also shared here. So in next session, we will be taking class of hyperthyroidism. Thank you. Have a nice day.